Schuss lowers his shoulder, cuts the middle, drops it off for Jones. He stops and shoots one.
Logan and I met when we were, it was Pee Wee Lacrosse, I think we were 12 years old. Prior to that, 4 or 5 years prior to that, we played against each other as kids, like neighboring cities. And we were always, I always knew who he was. He's the biggest kid out there. I think he hit puberty when he was 7 years old or something like that.
I mean, we've been playing with each other for so many years. He started playing together back in like Bantam Lacrosse, and so we've had a good bond off and on the floor.
So then we show up when we're 12 years old at the tryouts for that year, and we're just kind of staring at each other. Like, we didn't really want to talk to each other at first. And then, but from there, we obviously played the same position, played together, and the rest is history.
This is the first time you guys have played together professionally. I know it's only been, what, one full season?
Yeah, year and a half, basically, yeah.
Yeah, so does it, how does it affect your relationship with him, both on and off the floor?
Yeah, honestly, I could say that it hasn't really affected us off the floor. I think with us living with each other, we see each other all the time, so we're pretty comfortable with, you know, telling each other, hey, like, we should have done this on a play, or, you know, let's work on this. And it's pretty easy to communicate outside of lacrosse. You know, sometimes, especially in NLL, if players are fly-in players and you only can communicate via phone or text or email, it's pretty nice to be able to finish a game and then you go home together, and then, you know, throughout the week you're with each other talking about what could have gone better or what went right.
Give and go! Logan Schuss finds Mitch Jones, and he's got himself the hat trick tonight. But it spots Mitch Jones. Now Schuss with a shot. He scores! Logan,
what
Schuss
is a quality about him that most people don't know?
Most people don't know? Maybe not that most people don't know, but he's very generous. He's got a big heart to him. He's always looking to engage people, whether in a positive way, not picking on him, but so he likes to give out jabs, and sometimes from afar it might look like he's just trying to be funny, but he's really just trying to engage people and get people involved in any way he can. That's kind of what I've always liked about him, just generosity and a big heart on him.
You know, I think people see Mitch as a very like competitive person. You know, he's pretty tense on the bench and on during lacrosse, and for people that don't see him outside the game, I think they might look at him as just like a very fierce competitor and strictly business when it comes to on the floor stuff. But you know, he's been one of my best friends for the past 15 years for a reason, and you know, you can always kind of count on him when you need him outside of the game. And you know, he's an in guy. You know, if I, you know, had a bad day and I need to go for a beer, I'm like, hey Mitch, let's go grab a beer. And he's like, oh, sure. Like, I don't need to twist his arm, or, you know, if I need to talk to him about something, or we need to, you know, just hang out and watch TV, he's always there for me. So he's an end guy.